Away from that, the Speaker of Parliament, Rebecca Litwala-Kadaga, joins among many who have declared their worth. According to the IGG, a couple of or a number of, you know, civil servants have not declared their worth, and therefore is calling upon them to do so because the deadline is on 31st March 2021. Take a look.
Under the Leadership Code Act, all leaders are required to declare their assets to the Inspectorate of Government every 2 years. And this year, the exercise started on the 1st of March and will end on the 31st of March. The Deputy IGG, Mariam Wangadia, says that in the first 10 days, only 1,567 leaders out of the 30,000 leaders have declared their assets and liabilities, representing a percentage of 5.2.
...of declarations as envisaged under the Leadership Code Act. I would like to congratulate Parliament on this achievement of compliance at 94.43% and look forward to 100% compliance during this declaration period.
This was declared as the Speaker of Parliament, Rebecca Kadaga, submitted her declaration of income, assets and liabilities to the Inspectorate.
I just want to say again that I'll continue supporting the work of the IGG for more transparency and accountability, and within the institution, this appointment really strengthen our structures, strengthen our technical teams to ensure that issue of accountability have primacy.
Wangadia also urged leaders who are exiting office to ensure they fill the exit declaration form of assets and liabilities to avoid unlikely consequences, saying that before they have not been emphasizing this because they did not have a tribunal to prosecute defaulters.
There are various purposes for this. One is to comply with the Leadership Code Act. Failure by a leader to comply with this law is a breach. Attracts prosecution by the IGG before the Leadership Code Tribunal. Please note that the IG online declaration system database will continue to recognize a leader as still being in a leadership position.
Today, George Bamugemerere's term of office has expired, leaving the inspectorate with only one IGG out of the three that are supposed to run the institution. This story was compiled by Rachel Nakasi and Obedi Lutale for the news in Kampala.